inside scoop, and all your favorite stuff. Now, here's Wendy.
Doing swell. We have a really great show planned for you today. Singing sensation Joe Jonas is here. I know. He's the one who's the sexy middle Jonas brother who's launched now a solo career, and today he's going to perform his new hit song, Just in Love. And since we're both from Jersey, we're going to reenact a scene from the Jersey Shore. I'm going to be Snooki and he's going to be Situation. It should be funny. It should be funny. Life and Style magazine is here. They're joining us with this year's must-have beauty products. A question for you. Can a beautiful, overweight, small-town black girl make it as a fashion designer, image consultant in weight-conscious LA? Yes! Well, that's the story behind Chelsea Settles. She's MTV's newest reality star, so we're going to meet her. Her show premieres tomorrow night, and I can't wait to introduce her to you. Yeah. You guys, Christina Aguilera is back to being her old messy self. I got all the details. It's time for Hot Topics. Show done quickly. I can already feel myself sweating. You know how that happens. I've talked to you about this. Do I get the Botox under my arms to stop it? If I stop it under my arms, then I'm going to sweat under my wigs, or my wig, you know. And then, you know, the whole thing about walking out here, I tell you, the one thing that I've never done, which I don't want to do, is fall. But if I fell in front of you, I feel like I'd be falling in front of family, and I get it. You would laugh at me and with me, and I wouldn't mind it. Falling in front of you is not my big deal. It's my recovery, because as a woman of a particular age, I don't want to break a bone or anything like that. But I hold my breath when I walk out here. I just don't want to fall. My shoes are high today, 6 inches. So, I'm really excited because it's Columbus Day, and that means that there are a lot of people home watching the Wendy Show who normally don't get a chance to see us during the day. And I also want to shout out to all the school teachers in our Wendy audience. Making a difference. I think we must have the only school system in our town where they don't have off for Columbus Day. That has never happened in all my 47 years. Like, we were always off for Columbus Day all my life and all my son's life, and now all of a sudden, he's in school. Anyway, great weekend. I hope you had a good weekend too. Did you do a lot of, yeah. Did you do a lot of secret eating? This is like the first weekend I didn't do a bunch of secret eating this weekend. My niece came over. And so, you know, sometimes when you surround yourself by younger, you know, weight conscious, you know, these gals like in college and things like that, you know, you eat good stuff and you have great conversation, and she's only 19 and Miss Wendy loves the young girls. And so my niece was over this weekend and we had a really great time watching TV, sitting inside watching the nice weather. That's how I am. I'm like, when it's really nice out, I love to sit inside and watch nature. I don't really like to be involved. But anyway, here's the thing. I forgot all about Desperate Housewives last night. And I forgot all about Pan Am. Did you watch Desperate Housewives or Pan Am last night? You did? Not really? You're embarrassed too? I'm so embarrassed because, you know, I ride for these shows, but I swear I'm back on schedule tomorrow. Last night, my plans did not go accordingly at all. Remember, I was telling you on Friday I was going to hold Sunday dinner until 8 o'clock, and then me and my son were going to eat in the playroom, and we're on TV trays, and we're going to watch Kim Kardashian get married. What ended up happening was he was out with friends all day because he finished his homework early. And so I was inside watching. I watched a Bridezilla marathon. Then I got caught up with Lifetime. And then right at 8 o'clock when I was about to switch over and set up the TV and everything, Lifetime hit me with The Perfect Roommate. You know, being a Lifetime Nista that I am, I've seen every movie on Lifetime. So, but sometimes you like to see them again. But this one was made in 2011, and I never saw it. And it's starring Billy Moss as a 50-something widow who has a 25-year-old daughter, but the perfect roommate is 35 years old and lives with a daughter. And she's the one who seeks out rich guys and tries to get. Did you watch also?
Yeah.
You guys watched? They watched. It was so good. And then when I was watching, I got transfixed with the perfect roommate's wig. It might have been her hair, but to me, everybody's hair is a wig. Look, so I took a picture of the TV to show you. Don't you like that hair? She looks like a mannequin. I like it. So then, I asked you guys online at wendyshow.com, you know, how do you think I'd look with like a short wig like that? And 66% of you said that you don't like the short hair, you like the long hair. So just asking. In the meantime, so the perfect roommate was exactly what I was watching from 8 to 10. But in between for commercials, I went over to the Kardashians. And I was just in time last night to see I'm not the only one who thinks, well, duh. Chris Dumfries, duh. I was just in time to see this. Take a look.
I have a lot of advice for Chris. First and foremost, shut your mouth.
Oh, there he is.
Yo, sorry guys, I got lost again.
You guys watched the wedding, right? I kind of didn't feel so bad because I know tonight at 9 o'clock the wedding is going to be on A. This is the second part where we'll actually see Kim walk down the aisle and get married. So that's 8 o'clock Dancing with the Stars, because RadarOnline.com is now reporting that Cher will in fact be in the audience. Yeah. And then it's 9 o'clock the Kardashians. But then those Beverly Hills Housewives, and I had written them off for a moment, things are heating up over there, too. That comes on tonight as well. And P.S., did you guys see the season finale of Jersey Housewives last night? Forget about it. I was so busy. So the Michael Jackson tribute concert was this weekend in the U.K. Now, remember, when last we talked on Friday, I was telling you that people were dropping out left and right. Turns out, Christina Aguilera ended up stealing the headlines, and not in a good way. People are saying that this is a major faux pas for somebody who's, I mean, some people would call her fat. I think that she looks fine. You know, she's performing, so that's why she's so disheveled. Her hips have spread, but I love it when skinny girls gain weight, secretly. Secretly, don't, all right, some of us thicker, more juicy girls, don't you secretly love it when skinny girls gain weight and they don't know how to handle it? It's a little mean, but you know. Anyway, here's another photo of her, and I love this one. Look, she's about to take a spill. Look down at her feet. Look at her feet. Look! Look, that was exactly what you think. It was 4 o'clock in the morning, and she was coming out of a nightclub. And she, look. And she's wearing a smile on her face. Like, that's not even the, I'm about to fall. That's,
I feel good. Somebody catch me.
Look, skyscraper pumps, very tricky to walk in. And there she is. And guess what? She never hit the ground. Her bodyguard caught her, which means she's not that heavy. No matter what you might want to think about, she might be a little, you know, hippie. You know, she's hippie, but she's short. She's still catchable, unlike some of us who are on our own. This is what I was thinking. Riddle me this, and I think I've talked to you about this before, but I was reminded of the loveliness and the beauty of Leona Lewis this weekend. Look at her sing. She's over there. Nobody cares. This is all I'm saying. Have you ever heard of being pretty for no reason? Like, why? She got her nose fixed for us. She does good spray tan. She looks like Shaquita, my wig head. She's got really pretty eyes. She's got really pretty, and she's got a really great voice, yet no one cares. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, like, she'd be perfect to marry a count or a baron. Do you know how I tell you sometimes? Like if a girl really wants to hook up and marry well, you just go over to Europe, you know, for like a year, and you put yourself out there, and you come back with a count or a baron. Anyway. I like Leona Lewis. I just can't figure out any of her songs. Do you know any of her songs?
Yeah.
Oh, yes, you do, and I do, too. Can I tell you which one it is? Because Michael Newborn from Hot Topics reminded me this morning. Do you know when you're watching Lifetime and that song comes on in between every single description of a movie? So what if you make it? You know that song? That's Leona Lewis. Who knew? So, friend to the show, Fantasia is just making another mess. First of all, you know she's pregnant by a married man. Well, she already has a daughter. The daughter is around 10 years old, something like that. Anyway, remember the married man that she met in the cell phone store?
Yeah.
And then they tried to deny it?
Yeah.
And they tried to deny their love? Anyway, she's pregnant. Well, you know, when last we talked about Fantasia, which was last season, towards the end, though, I was telling you that she was supposed to star in the late gospel singer Mahalia Jackson's biopic. There's Mahalia. So, according to the New York Post, the producers are really upset now because Fantasia concealed her pregnancy. And then, to make matters worse, the members of Mahalia Jackson's family are angry because she's pregnant by a married man. That's not very Christian-like. Anyway, they're saying that Fanny's behavior is going to tarnish Mahalia's name. There's something to be said for that, right? I mean, coveting another? That's not nice, Fantasia. It's a whole lot of messiness. Fantasia, you need to stop being so messy and start being more accountable for the things that you do. Remember when you were on Broadway and they were saying that you weren't showing up and you just kind of messed up a whole production of The Color Purple, right? A Color Purple. Do you remember that, you guys, years ago? I mean, you had such an opportunity. You know, you're an American Idol, and Simon and everybody, we love you. But we just can't have your back with this one, Fantasia. You messed up Mahalia Jackson money. Really? Please, family of Mahalia Jackson, please do not call Jennifer Hudson to do this. Jennifer Hudson does not want to be associated with anything bigger than a size zero. Definitely. Sun in the sky. You guys, you'll never believe which celebrity called Kate Winslet about career advice. Snooki. Well. That's a good picture of Snooki. Isn't this a good, this is a good picture. Look, Snooki has made it no secret. She idolizes Kate Winslet, and that Snooki's favorite movie is The Titanic. So Snooki dreams of becoming an actress, and Kate's response was, what's a Snooki? Kate? Hey, Kate. As much as you might not want to admit it, she's just as popular as you. You know exactly who Snooki is. Winslet's advice, because the thing about being an actress is not for you, but you're creating your empire. You got your sunglasses going on, you start your pint-sized clothing line. You could be queen of the world. There she is in that scene. Oh, Snooki, we love you. Listen, still to come, this year's must-have beauty products, but up next, the sexy and talented Joe Jonas is here. Get ready to see TV's most respected journalist in a whole new light.
How you doing?
It's News Anchor Week.
Monday on Wendy.
The dean of TV journalism is back on the couch, and he's ready to dish. Dan Rather. 7 years after he was axed by CBS, he's fighting back. And wait until you hear what he has to say about Katie Couric.
Wendy Williams is brought to you by KFC. Come in today and taste why fresh is better.
Refer to our first guest as the middle Jonas. Others call him the sexy Jonas, but I'd like to refer to him as the Jonas brother with the best hair. He's one third of the worldwide Jonas brother phenomenon, who's now breaking away from the pack and making a name for himself with his new solo CD, Fast Life. Please welcome to our show the very grown up and very sexy Joe Jonas.
Thank you.
It's a warm welcome for sure.
As you can see, you've got all kinds of fans, and I even see some of the cougars cheering and drooling.
Those cougars out there. I gotta say, your shoes are incredible.
Thank you.
Have you guys seen her shoes?
Thank you, Joe. Thank you.
Poor squirrel, but they're really awesome.
You know, you and I have something in common that's gonna bond us immediately. Number one, we are middle children.
Oh, yeah.
So we are.
We get blamed for everything.
We get blamed for everything, but we're very diplomatic. We have a way of bringing everybody together because we're used to having to do that with our siblings and our families. The other thing is that we're both from Jersey.
That's right. People from Jersey, we hold each other together.
We hold each other together. What's your mall when you were growing up in Jersey?
Garden State Mall.
Garden State Mall. Yeah. Mine was the Monmouth Mall.
Okay.
So, yeah.
I had Premise Park Mall, too, was my mall. I was right in between those two.
Yeah, Premise Park Mall. And then when I was growing up, it was Cherry Hill Mall for the holidays.
My parents, that's where they grew up for a while. So.
Really? Yeah. So, Jersey Shore?
I've been to Jersey Shore quite a bit.
Okay.
When I went, though, I didn't really have a lot of Snookies and
yes.
Pauly D's there.
Yeah.
They were just kind of younger at the time, but, I mean, Jersey Shore, we would always go there for the summertime, just hang out and
yeah.
whatnot.
So how does it feel to be a sex symbol?
Wow. I guess it's interesting to say that I get my sex symbol. I guess I don't tell myself that, but it's a compliment.
But I when he pulled up to the studio, the harem of women were all outside here in the studio. They keep piping up. You're now, how old are you? 22.
22, yeah.
22 years old. You've got great hair. That Details magazine cover was really terrific.
Thank you very much. You also have great hair.
Thank you. Thank you.
Three things in common.
Yeah, three things, yeah. But mine's a wig. Is yours?
I'm not allowed to say.
Oh. Is your hair manageable? Are you able to do it yourself?
Yeah, I can do it myself. For events and whatnot, I have people help me out. But
yes.
Luckily, having shorter hair, it makes it a lot easier. I've had quite a few stages of hair.
As we've seen.
Yeah.
Yeah. So how's the dating scene? You know, tracking you, which I have been for years. I know that you've dated a lot of famous women. Are you single now?
I am single. There goes those cougars again.
Those are the cougars. Would you consider having a girlfriend, or are you single by choice at this point?
I mean, I think we always look for somebody special.
Yeah.
So I'm always open to it if it's the right person.
Yeah. Well, one of your brothers is married. Is that Kevin?
Yeah, Kevin, my older brother. He just got married, and they've got a beautiful home in New Jersey also.
Yeah.
And they're coming to the show tonight. It's
going
to be fun.
That's great. Do you get pressured by your family to have a girl?
My mom would love for me to have, you know, eventually somebody to settle down with.
Eventually.
But I think she knows that I'm young and enjoying just traveling and whatnot. And
yeah.
I love how these girls are pointing to themselves. Right here. I know your mom.
What kind of girls do you like? Do you like a pop singer, or do you like a college girl?
I like everybody. Personally, I think it's all about the person. If they're a good person at the end of the day, then I think that's all that matters.
Do you drink?
Yeah.
Like a fish?
Like a fish? Not like a fish. Unfortunately, I gotta work quite a lot, but
he's responsible. I was just trying to trap you. Good.
Well, they don't really know what's in our coffee cups.
No, and we don't tell them.
We don't tell them. No.
Don't make the face. The jig is up. All right. So look, in your new video, Just in Love, it's very steamy, and there's a big difference in Joe Jonas from the Jonas Brothers and Juicy Joe Jonas in the video.
It was a fun video to shoot. We shot in Paris. The only thing that was a little bit bizarre about it was I was the only one that spoke English. Because everybody was speaking French. So we would go into these scenes, and then I wouldn't know when they would say cut or...
Let your body talk.
There you go.
Uh-huh. Well, here's the thing. Joe, now that you're all grown up and you're on your own career-wise, does this mean that the Jonas Brothers have broken up?
No, we're still a band. We're taking a little time off to do individual projects, but probably next year or the year following, we're going to get back together and make some more music.
and it comes out tomorrow.
Yeah.
Tell us about it. Who's on it, and what are y'all doing on it?
Well, I've written with a bunch of different artists and producers for this project. I got the opportunity to do a remix with Lil Wayne recently on my current single, and it's been great. Just the fact that I'm able to make music and have this opportunity to share it with the world, I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah. Is it difficult to grow up in front of all of our eyes?
I think when you're young, it definitely can be difficult. I mean, when it's always nonstop and the traveling and whatnot. But I think, luckily, I've had a good family, and doing it with my family made it a lot easier.
And the hair on your face helps remind us that you're a man. You know?
I noticed how she said face.
Yeah. Listen to me. Since Joe and I are both from New Jersey, I thought it would be fun if I played, if we recreated a scene from the Jersey Shore. Joe, our costumes are right here.
Oh, perfect.
You're gonna be Situation.
All right.
And
I love it.
And I'm gonna be Snooki. Oh. And look at me. Velcro's onto your back.
Oh, I love it.
Okay. Don't forget your sunglasses.
All right, cool.
And look, this is what this scene is.
I love it.
All right, here's your script. Okay. This is good, kid. Listen, everybody. Joe's going to stick around and perform his new single, Just In Love, later in the show. Don't miss it. We'll be right back. With so many beauty products on the market, it can be tough to keep up with what's hot and what's not. Well, Life and Style magazine has done all the work for us. They've tested out hundreds of products for their 2011 Beauty Awards, and here to share a few of those must-haves is editor-at-large Rachel Zalis. Rachel, welcome back to the show. I'm so glad that you're here. All right, so let's get going, because I see that, well, first of all, before we start, how do you decide which products are the best?
Right, we take this very seriously at Life and Style. We tested over 200 products over 2 months period and have an all-star panel. I'm talking Kim Kardashian's makeup artist, Joyce Benelli, Campbell McCauley, who does Cameron Diaz and Kate Winslet, and celebrities like Maria Menounos and Olivia Munn and Lauren Conrad. So you know you can trust these beauty products.
Yes. All right, so now here are just a few of them on the table. We're going to start with nails.
Okay.
I love the concept of these Sally Hansen nails.
Okay, everyone agreed these are a game changer in the nail polish industry.
Okay.
Our whole panel. Now, you know how many times you've left the manicure if you spend a lot of money and it chips like 5 minutes after you leave?
Yes.
Okay, right? We all know how that works. So there is no polish, no wetness, no dry time. Basically, these strips, they come in the package, and it is so easy. I made my nails gold. These are the strips. They've lasted 4 days already.
I gotta get in on this.
The best thing is that you can mix and match. It's a huge trend.
Put one on. Let me see how that works.
So you basically, it's so easy. You separate it.
Okay.
You literally stick it on your nail.
Now, will an air bubble form underneath?
Nope. You literally just press it on, and drag it over the edge, and it rips right off.
And
you literally have this little buffer to just take away any of the extra.
Oh my gosh, that's good. That's really good.
Look how cute, right?
Thank you.
Leopard, I
love it. Game changer, you're right. All right, let's talk about this eye dust.
Okay, everyone's going to lust after this dust. It's Napoleon Perdis. He's a celebrity makeup artist. All the gossip girls love his products. And what I love most about this is, a lot of times you don't know how much to put on. So
right.
This has a sifter in it. You basically just shake it. You open it up, and it gives you just the amount that you need for your one application. And you can see how beautiful.
It is beautiful. I have it on my lower lids. Do you want to look?
Look how gorgeous. I have it on too.
You have it on too?
I have it on too. Look at my lids. How cute are we in our.
It's good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So basically, you can see how beautiful the color. It has mineral oils in it too, so it actually conditions the eyes at the same time. So it's beautiful.
That is nice.
Yes.
All right. And so now let's talk about this. What are these? Makeup removers and a
swab.
This
is one of the best things. It's Japanese beauty fixation. Now, basically, when you travel and you want makeup remover, you don't want to lug a big bottle. So these are amazing. They're 24 tubes that are already pre-filled, and it's so easy to carry with you.
What do you
basically,
do?
Basically, you see this blue line right here?
Oh.
You just snap it right there.
Oh.
All the liquid drains to the bottom.
Oh.
And you can see on my hand how it just removes that makeup.
Oh, my gosh.
How great is that? And it's so great. too, because it's really specific. So if you have a little eyeliner or something smudged, it works like magic.
That's really good.
Absolutely love that.
Okay, I love these. I swear by these.
Okay,
Let's talk about them.
A white, bright smile.
Yeah.
And these are the 3D Crest white strips. Now, literally, this can remove 13 years of stains from your teeth. And this is the most effective whitening ingredient that they have on the market.
And I must tell you,
it's the same they use in the dentist's office.
They're really comfortable to wear. They stay on your teeth. You get a bottom and a top and a generous, because I have lots of teeth and sometimes the strips are a little short. Very generous width.
Yes.
Very good.
Okay.
All right, caviar.
This is the Alterna Caviar Overnight Hair Serum. Now,
do tell.
Hello, who doesn't love caviar, right? Now, we know it's fabulous to eat, but it's also fabulous for the hair. Feel, put your hand in there, give it a little pump.
And then
feel how luxurious it has omega-3s, and it really enriches your hair overnight. It's great for damaged or color-treated
hair. This is $38 normally.
Yes. I mean, but caviar is expensive. I think we need some champagne with this.
You gotta treat your hair.
And Maria Menounos actually used this and said it fixed her hair literally
She's got good
overnight
hair.
And didn't leave any residue on her pillow. That's a big thing.
She's been here too. Hi, Maria.
So it's really
yummy. Now let's talk about this. $28, by the way, is, these are 54, the Crest strips. We didn't even go over any of the prices. But anyway, $28, this is a face mask. Tell us about this.
Now listen, it could cost you hundreds of dollars just for one facial.
Yeah.
Three or four in one box. This is the Karuna Karma set. It has everything that's anti-aging and antioxidant and hydrating, and it's beautiful. They use great minerals and like Chinese licorice and chamomile and stuff. So they're incredible facials.
What I like about it is that it's hydrating, and it's like a piece of tissue that goes over your face. This is our audience member. Her name is Brooke, right, Brooke?
And so this should sit for about 10 to 20 minutes.
10 to 20.
You take it right off, and look how beautiful and glowing.
That takes care of all the drinking you did over the weekend.
Good for the hangover.
Brooke, how do you feel?
And my skin feels very hydrated. It feels amazing. I love it.
Very nice. Well, this is all great. Rachel, thank you so much for being
thank
here
you.
Again. We love you, Life and Style Magazine. For more information about these fabulous products, go to wendyshow.com. And guess what, audience? You're all going home with all of them. Don't miss it. Wendy, and our next guest stars in a new MTV reality show. It's a cross between the glamorous life of the people on the hills and the weight-conscious Ruby. It's the story of a girl who's ditched her small-town roots to pursue her dreams of working in LA's fashion industry, all while overcoming low self-esteem and struggling with her own weight issues. Take a look.
I am gonna change. It's not even a question anymore. It's not an option. It's like, I have to.
The apparently delightful Chelsea Settles.
Make sure nothing's out.
No, everything is in. Chelsea, you are beautiful.
Oh, thank you so much.
And stylish. I see your nails, your
I had
shoes.
To come prepared. I watched the show. I watched the
I
show.
I appreciate it. And we're going to be watching your show. You start tomorrow night on MTV. So let's just find out, how did you get this show? Like, where did you come from? What?
Honestly, like, not even kidding. I was browsing MTV's website, and there was a casting call. They were looking to follow an overweight girl, and I wrote an email. And I don't know how to work, like, camera equipment, so I had to, like, scrounge around, have someone make a casting tape for me.
Yes.
My grandma told me I was wasting my time, always had some crazy scheme going on.
Yes.
And hi, Grandma!
Yeah. from right outside of Pittsburgh, so there's not a whole lot of, you know, television going on there. So, you know, but I'm glad that you went for it. Now, you moved to a city where the idea of beauty is skewed. Shout out to all of our friends in L.A., but you know how you do to us big girls. It's not nice.
No.
So tell me some of the challenges of living in L.A.
I don't know. Like, I've always dreamed of living there since I was 13. I just really didn't have the courage. I figured, okay, I'll lose weight first, and as soon as I do that, then I can move to L.A. But I was at the end of my rope and just had to do it. But, I mean, I was afraid that I would be the only fat person in L.A., just the only one walking on the street. I mean, of course, you have, like, people staring.
Yes.
There's taunting that goes along with that.
Well, there's not a lot of fat people in L.A.
No, not at all.
I mean, so you're not the only one, but there's not a whole lot.
I was definitely the minority.
Yeah. But. Now, you're 24 years old. What's the hardest thing about moving 3,000 miles away from home?
I'm the only child, so it was leaving my mom. She's sick, so I was just afraid that she would think I was, you know, abandoning her. And
yeah.
Just a lot of guilt. But she wanted me to follow my dreams, so she was really supportive. It was weighing on me.
Now, they told me that you were, like, 240 pounds. You don't look
240 pounds.
You've lost a lot of weight. When you started?
When I started, I was 324 pounds.
A real fatty.
Yes.
Well, so who is this girl here today? How much weight have you lost?
Honestly, I don't even know who she is. I've been, like, fixated on the scale and a number, and now it's just about being healthy.
You're
and
sexy.
Feeling confident. Oh, God, I don't know.
You look a little like relative to Lisa Ray, the actress.
Oh.
Yeah, beautiful. So, how was it dealing with weight issues growing up? I see that you hide food, and you had a messy car, and you got all that together. Well, no, you know.
No, it is.
Those
it is
of us
what
who hidden food in their rooms can relate.
I internalized a lot of it, so I would hide myself from people. When I would go to, you'll see in the show, like, I would go to school, I wanted to show up early because I didn't want to, you know, be in the way of people. Like, I would have to find a desk away from everyone, and I don't know, I just really
isolated
myself.
So that they wouldn't catch fat angles?
Yeah, I would have to position the desk at 11 o'clock, so this role was hiding, and my boobs weren't hanging over the desk, and I couldn't focus on anything that was going on in the classroom. It was that way with, like, you know, social things. I just really isolated myself.
Isolated. But you're still a very pretty girl. You were pretty, I guess, even at your heaviest. That's some of the footage that we saw. Do you have a little boyfriend or somebody? Do I sound like a grandma here? You have a boyfriend?
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah. A little something, a little drive-by, a little something-something.
No. Okay, it's more than that. I've been with him for about 5 years. He's my first and only boyfriend.
Oh, your first and only?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you don't expect that's going to last too long. I mean, you're out there in L.A. and you're hot. I mean, I'm just saying. Hey, how old are you? 24?
24.
Oh yeah, you got plenty of time left. you have a little roommate on the show, and she's a thin girl, and you never
knew
her.
The odd couple.
Tell us
Absolutely
all about your roommate.
Opposite. Jenna, she's really amazing, but just tattooed, and, you know, we're opposite. She's from a different type of family than mine.
Yes.
Like, you know. Just opposites. I was nervous. I was a nervous wreck. When I meet people, like, before, I would automatically assume that they would see my weight, write me off.
Yes.
Like, okay, she's overweight. We're done with her.
I think that your head is a lot fuller with that than it actually is in reality. You're a delightful young lady, and you're very beautiful. And it was really nice to meet you, Chelsea Settles.
Yeah.
On MTV. Don't move. Still to come, Joe Jonas is going to perform, but up next, it's time for Ask Wendy. I really want you to be a part of my live studio audience, so if you're ever in the New York City area and you want free tickets, go to wendyshow.com. I'll see you soon. Time for Ask Wendy. How you doing?
How you doing?
I'm doing well. How can I help?
My question is, first, my name is Kendall. My ex-boyfriend is a complete jerk. I took him back once, and he pulled a disappearing act. So now he's calling me saying, I love you. I want to get back together. How do I tell him it's over?
He's dead to us. Look, this is what I mean. Don't answer his phone calls, not even to tell him to stop calling you. Okay. Do not answer his phone calls. Do not answer his texts.
Okay.
If he comes to your house and starts ringing the doorbell, that becomes obnoxious. Call the cops.
Okay.
Make sure that he doesn't see you moving your blind like you actually see him. Just so when you get back home after the Wendy show, position one of the windows where you can just see outside without touching anything. You know what I mean?
Got
you. He's dead to us. He's dead. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome, Kendall. How you doing?
How you doing? Hi, Wendy. My name is Tiffany, and my ex-maid of honor dropped out of my wedding a month before I got married, and now she's calling me asking to reimburse her for my bachelorette party. Should I pay her back?
How much money are we? Well, this lady right here says no, but look, it's easy to say that. However, how much would you have to pay her back?
Over $500. Oh. Well, over $500.
Okay, well, this is what I've learned as I've gotten into my maturity and my grown woman on. The way you really hurt somebody is to give them exactly what they want and ignore them. Like, you've picked the most eloquent way of saying, basically, you know, you are a non-factor in my life. You write it down beautifully. You send her the money, tax included, if you can afford it. See, to me, that's a much better than just ignoring her, you know? Do you know what I mean? That's what I've learned as a grown woman, that the way you get somebody back is to give them exactly what they ask for. Yeah. Good luck. If that makes any sense to you, good luck with that. Up next, Joe Jonas is back to perform his smash hit, Just in Love. Keep it here. For the Wendy Williams Show is brought to you by back to perform his new single Just in Love from his solo album Fast Life. Give it up for Juicy Joe Jonas.
Trying to change it, try to tell it don't change. Talk love and they say it sounds crazy. Love's like a mobile when you're angry. You understand why you wanna change it. Girl, listen to me. Girl, I'm just in love with you. Hey, I'm just in love with you. Hey, don't worry to you. I'm just in love with you. I'm just in love with you. Oh, yeah. When I told you I would never leave you, do you hear what I say? Sounds crazy. Love's even more wild when you're angry. Understand why you wanna change it. Girl, listen to me. Your head in mine.
Michelle for being here. Joe Jonas, everybody, pick up your copy of his CD. It's called Fast Life in stores now. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
Get ready to see TV's most respected journalists in a whole new light.
How you doing?
It's News Anchor Week. Every day they're taking on the hot topics.
So let's talk Katie Couric
and each other.
If she invites you on her new talk show, would you go on?
I think you're more likely to see water run uphill.
Don't miss News Anchor Week. All next week on Wendy.
Welcome back. I want to thank, what was that? In live TV on the Messy Wendy Show. Welcome back, everybody. I want to thank today's guest, Joe Jonas, Life and Styles Magazine's Rachel Zalis. Also, MTV reality star Chelsea Settles. It was really nice to meet you, young lady. Of course, you, my co-host, my studio audience. Tomorrow, the very handsome and talented Malcolm Jamal Warner will be here, plus the always outspoken Reverend Al Sharpton. And we'll meet two of the most recent cast-offs from The Biggest Loser. I love you for watching today, and I'll see you next time on Wendy. Bye.